A lot of people ask me this question when they're debating whether or not to enter the radiography field. How much does a radiographer earn? Now, if you go to thesick.com, you will see a large scale of different annual salaries. So, today, I will overshare with you all the juicy numbers, my salaries from the past 7 years, how much I've earned in 2020, and I'll also show you my payslip from last fortnight. Before I get into the juicy numbers, I need to clarify two big things, or myths. Number one, every state and territories has a different pay scale. And from memory, we have the lowest median radiographer salary. So even if you have the same experience and expertise as I do, but if you work in Sydney, New South Wales, you will probably get paid more than I do. But then again, you probably pay more for living expense in Sydney, so it's all give and take. Now next up, the question that I always, always, always get from radiography students, do I make more money working in private or public? Now it all depends. But off the record, you might make more money doing ultrasound in a private clinic comparing to a public hospital. And that's because some private clinics are happy to pay sonographers, ultrasound people, a pretty high hourly rate, say $80 to $90 per hour. Now, don't do ultrasound just because you want to get more money. Ultrasound is very hard and it is very boring and I didn't like it. If you're specialized in CT or MRI, you may be able to negotiate yourself a pretty good hourly rate as well in the private sector, say maybe $50 to $60 per hour. You might get more money in the private sector because you can do some negotiation before you sign a contract. And that's why there's a conception that you can make more money working in the private. But in the public sector, there is an extremely clear-cut award rate. So you cannot negotiate for a higher hourly rate. You have to fit in the paying grade scale. But personally, I think as a newish MRI radiographer, I make more money working in a public hospital. And let me explain. See, in the public sector, we get paid by the book. Every year my salary increases with an inflation rate of 2.5%. So even if you don't get promoted, you are guaranteed that your salary will steadily increase over time. Also, we are protected by the union, so every 4 to 5 years we can negotiate for better pay. Whereas in the private sector, it kind of depends what the company has decided, so it can be a little bit vague. And on top of that, we have a benefit of sacrificing part of our pre-tax salary so we can pay less tax, equal to having more money in my pocket. Also, we can get up to 8 weeks of paid leave a year working in the public hospital, but you only get 4 weeks of annual leave working in the private sector. So I'm biased and I definitely prefer working in a public hospital. All right, here comes the juicy numbers. Let me show you my hourly rate from 2013 to now 2021. If you want to know more detail, you can check out one of my other video. In 2013, during my 6 months internship, my hourly rate was $17.50. To put that in perspective, I got paid $22.50 in my part-time job selling suitcases. In 2014, my first qualified radiographer job in a private clinic, my hourly rate was $28. And that was pretty standard for a new graduate. In 2015, I started working in a public hospital and my hourly rate was $31.80. And here are all the numbers for the next 6 years. So now I get paid $47 per hour, making my annual salary $93,490, which is great to year four for those who know more about the radiography world. So that's pretty much the top of my earning potential, unless I get promoted to a more senior role, say a grade 3 position. So we don't get paid as much as doctors do, but when I talk to other people about my hourly rate, the feedback that I get would be, it is still better than a routine 9-to-5 office job. The one thing about radiographer is that we can always earn a little bit more, sometimes even 30% more, doing overtimes and shift works. So, which brings me to my pay summary 2020. So, my gross salary was $119,900 and my base annual salary was $90,300. So, roughly $30,000 extra on top of my base salary. Remember I mentioned pre-tax salary sacrificing? So, I had roughly $25,000 pre-tax deduction, like car lease, meal entertainment, mortgage payment. So making my taxable gross income to be $94,700. And from that $94,700 taxable income, I had to pay $24,700 as my income tax. So for those who don't live in Australia, the income tax here is roughly 32 to 37%. So it is quite a bit. Anyway, to keep it simple, let me show you my pay slip from last fortnight. So every fortnight, I work 80 hours as a basic. So I get $3,785 every 2 weeks. And in the last fortnight, I also worked 13 and a half hours of overtime, which is double pay. So that gave me an extra $1,276. And I also get allowances for being on call or working a late shift or having a postgraduate diploma. So all of those inconveniences are compensated financially, adding an extra $735 in my pay. So 35% of my pay was from all those extra things that I did. So in summary, I hope I gave you a better understanding of a radiographer's salary, and let me know what you think.